On this piece of wasteland in the town of Khanaqeen in northern Iraq, hundreds of families have sought refuge, fleeing from the latest round of fighting that has thrown the country into turmoil. They are but a drop in the ocean of the hundreds of thousands of Iraqis who've been internally displaced as a result. Men, women and children, mainly Sunni, whose homes and livelihoods have been destroyed. This 60-year-old man from Diyala is one of them. His name is Fuad. He has three little girls. He's now unable to provide for them.
There was shelling, continuous and indiscriminate shelling from all sides, shell landing on our roofs, so we had to flee.
Fuad is in no doubt as to who's to blame.
I blame the government, those we elected. Once we elected them, they turned against us. Had we elected foreigners, they would have treated us better.
But there are even more severe cases in this camp, like 4-year-old Abdel Sattar and his father Arkan. Abdel Sattar is paralyzed from the neck down. The shelling was so intense in his hometown of Mughdadiyah that his father had no time to grab anything else, not even his wheelchair. Arkan picked up his son and ran. Now the child struggles to cope in the scorching heat, his father unable to find him the necessary medical treatment. Little Shayma is another suffering child. She's unable to move her legs. Her mother says she had almost saved enough money to get her treatment, only for that all to be lost when the fighting forced them to flee their home. Now she too struggles to take care of her disabled daughter in a camp lacking the most basic necessities.
We desperately need water tanks, medicine for chronic illnesses, doctors, and we need an ambulance. Yes, some things have been donated to us, but we need much more.
The average temperature here in July is 45 degrees Celsius, but can reach over 50. The severe heat has led to 2 cases of miscarriages, according to officials. Just filming here in such heat was a challenge, but suddenly it started to pour.
Already struggling to cope with the scorching heat, those who have little shelter by these flimsy tents now have to endure the rain, which has suddenly started to pour down here. Some see it as a blessing, but nonetheless, under these circumstances, it is more suffering for those already displaced.
Fortunately, it didn't rain long enough to flood out the tents, but there is a real risk of that happening if it rains for longer. As with every conflict in the world, it is the most vulnerable who suffer the most. This camp in Khanaqeen and the children who, despite all the hardships, continue to smile are an example of just how true that is. But like little Shayma, they are also a testament to the fact that while conflicts may take people's lives, they cannot kill people's will to live. Jamal Al-Shayal, Al Jazeera, Khanaqeen, Northern Iraq.